Hello students, today I am going to teach the topic Green Cloud Computing. So let's proceed with the concept as a Green Cloud Computing. According to Wikipedia, cloud computing is a collection of variety of computing concepts in which thousands of computers communicate in real time to provide a seamless experience to the user, as if or she is using single huge resource. That the system provides multiple facilities like web data stores, huge computing resources, data processing servers, etc. The concept of cloud computing is around since early 1950s, although the term was not coined back then. Time sharing systems was how it was addressed back then. During the period 1960 and 1990, the host of experts did hint the area of cloud computing in their different references as well as quotes. The early 1990s, even telecommunication companies began offering VPN, that is a virtual private network, instead of dedicated connections, which were decent in quality of service but were comparatively cheaper. In 1999, Salesforce.com was among one of the first to provide enterprise applications via websites. This move aided the advent of cloud computing, which was introduced around 2002 by Amazon. Cloud computing can be considered as hierarchy of concepts which comprise of several models. And these models are like software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. According to the National Institute of Standards and Technology, the major objective of cloud computing is to maximize the shared resources, and at the same time, the disadvantages is its high infrastructure cost and unnecessary power consumption. Also, NIST says that the major objective of cloud computing is to maximize resources. At the same time, the disadvantage is its high performance cost and unnecessary power consumption. Global warming has been a big concern of late. With high power consumption and CO2 emission acting as a catalyst to increase the same, the world has become highly protective about the environment, with inputs from contributors such as Greenpeace, Environmental Protection Agency of the United States, and the Climate Savers Computing Initiative, to name a few. With continuously increasing popularity and usage of cloud computing and increasing awareness of the people across the globe towards the use of eco-friendly resources, has forced the researchers to detect concepts towards eco-friendly energy efficient flavor of cloud computing, and that is called as a green computing. According to the previous work has done, green computing facilitates the reduction of power consumption and CO2 emission along with reutilization of energy in an efficient way. With this cloud usage, thousands of data centers in order to process the user queries, and to run these data centers, bulk amount of power is used for cooling and other processes. Every year, this power consumption is gradually increasing, and green cloud computing endeavors to reduce the same, so playing a helpful role in the current issues. There are various techniques and algorithms to use minimize the expenditure. Among various avenues, one area of research focuses on reduction of energy consumption by computer servers, whereas the other lays stress on dynamic cluster server configuration to reduce total power consumption by balancing load and effectively utilize only a subset of resources at hand. Similarly, dynamic provides a CPU clock frequency scaling, again incorporate some form of a load balancing to save power during different data center. The first one was developed by Green Grid, called as a power usage effectiveness, that is a PUE metric to measure the effectiveness of data center. The reminder is that the organization need to follow the green cloud computing concepts. As the study and practices of designing, the manufacturing, using and disposing computing resources with minimum environmental damages. Steps are like that: algorithm efficiency, resource allocation, virtualization by IBM, Intel and some AMD like company, then terminal server, that is a thin client, and terminal services, then power management, then data center, power, Google, that is adopted by Google corporations, and material recycling. As the green computing uses supply chain energy usage, then green data centers are nowadays become very pop-up area in the environment of a cloud environment. There are certain steps for green data centers, like can diagnose the opportunity and the problem, then measure and manage, provide cool blanking panels, virtualize and build. With this, there is a issue of server virtualization and energy aware consolidation. Now, data centers are backbone of this cloud computing. The data center housing the clouds offer use of lot of energy. Data center are the facility that houses computer systems and their related component. The power consumed by data centers mainly constitutes of power required to run the actual equipment and the power used up by devices to cool the equipment. To cool the system in the data center, we usually make the use of precision air conditioners that control temperature, humidity throughout the day and can also be managed remotely. As more and more people switch to cloud computing, the energy consumed by it becomes significant. In the area of great concern for greener environment, this area in the cloud computing should be considered. It is from this basic need that green cloud computing arrives. Green cloud computing is basically the computing solutions to the problems of energy consumptions. These solutions also aim at reducing the operational expenses, which you call as a OPEX. The increase in operational cost reduces the marginal profit of cloud service providers. The power consumption of data center also has a non-eligible impact on the increase in carbon emissions and global warming. So, there is a need to develop energy efficient solutions to cloud computing. For this, in an in-depth analysis of power efficiency of clouds need to be done. As the use of green computing has increased substantially in recent past, a lot of research has been done to incorporate, to enhance the applicability of green cloud in a real life scenarios. With this help of various parameters, uses of energy is dramatically increasing in a data center, as introduced by improving energy efficiency of the running data center. The Green Grid is proposing same parameters like power usage effectiveness and data efficiency. According to certain research, PUE is a measure of how efficiently a computer data center uses its power. As we know that if the value of PUE approaching is 1.0, it means efficiency is 100% and full power is used by IT equipments. As implement the green scheduling algorithm combines with natural network predictor for reducing energy consumption in cloud computing. What exactly written in this algorithm? That is a green scheduling algorithm. In this algorithm, the server predicts the load from time to the time it takes for restarting and calculate the peak load. According to the peak load, the number of server state is decided. This server loads is on high priority. As a part of green computing, there are certain grid matrices power measurement has been also innovated. With the help of that, exactly server load, that is generation of the emission of CO2, has been calculated. There is another issue, that is cooling. So cooling is one of the major issues, consumes huge amount of energy in the data center. Previously, the cooling is done by using mechanical refrigerator that supplied chilled water for IT equipment. Nowadays, pre-cooling, also called as free cooling, that free cooling minimizes the use of mechanical cooling. Like Facebook deploys their data centers in Sweden, which has cold and dry climate. Microsoft leaves server in the open air in order to cool and servers easily. Also, Google uses river water to cool their data center. There are different hardware technologies like virtualization and software technologies like software efficient algorithm used to decrease the consumption of this energy, which is very important aspect of this cloud computing as a green computing. As the architecture of a data center is of different types, such as we considers like an it's in a two-tier or three-tier. In all such kind of architecture, energy efficiency has to be analyzed. The data center efficiency usually calculated by performance delivered per watt. As green computing is adapted by many of the data centers. So, the number of studies have shown that ideal servers consumes around 66% of energy compared to their fully loaded configuration. The management of memory module and other factors contribute to this energy consumption. So, we can save considerable amount of water if the workloads are connected on minimum number of computing servers. So, enabling the shutting down of idle server. Basically, the different power management techniques in computer architecture consist of dynamic voltage scaling as well as dynamic frequency scaling, then dynamic shutdown. As this green IT developing the regions for development in ICT, that is information and communication technology, then moving processor and data closer to the user, then public policy which measures like an example, Germany example, how they are properly utilizes the green computing for their data centers, then locating the data center in developing world, as well as they need to think about the economical growth. So in these factors, these are the regions where green IT is developing worldwide. As there is a need of the balancing energy in a data center. Now, in a data center which consists of different kinds of resources like a data storage, server, LAN, then on which they require power for operate of the every units and all. So there is a definitely a high power consumption for each and every resources which is a part of the data center. So we can say that there is also a kind of server consolidation. So as these are the energies which are consumed within a data center, because of that it will emit a high energy level or it is emit a CO2 level. The services of providers are registered in the cloud offer directory. The green broker access these services and organize it according to the price, time and the service that offer least CO2 emissions. The carbon emission directory keeps and store the data which contains information of energy and cooling efficiency of cloud services and data center. The green broker use the up-to-date information about services. Whenever the user requests for services, it contacts with a green broker. The green broker uses these directions and chooses the green offer and energy efficiency information and allocates the services on the private cloud and finally give the result to the end users. This directory idea is beautifully used by the scientists Halkeri and Garg and proposes new architecture called as a integrated green cloud architecture. Sometimes it's referred as a IGCA. Now in this architecture, exactly what are the part of the major concern? This consists of two elements, as one is the client and second is the server side. In the client side, manager and the user are present, which deals with execution destination of the job. In the server side includes green cloud middleware, green broker and sub broker layer of IGCA for organizing the information of the public cloud and provides the best green service to the users. The green cloud middleware has two components. The manager is the main head that deals with one component and stores all the information of middleware, the usage of users, the PC, the servers present on the private cloud, all the information. The frequency of each server like a high, medium and low. The energy usage, storage capacity and other information also exist in the component of the middleware. So on basis of that, there are certain advantages as well as disadvantages of this green cloud computing. As energy aware data center management, which for the OLPC project, then there is a low power computing platform as in a modern data centers, then managing computing loads which are mostly utilized for the number of resources are a part of a such a data center. Then there is a prioritization, then virtual technologies for a data center, then cooling data center which is of 42% from the all over world, and they are going to adapt the solar PV system for the energy generation and all. So we can say that a green learning in cloud computing is provided by virtualization. So virtualization is creating virtual entity. Using virtualization, multiple users can be accommodated on a single host. If there was no virtualization, each user would have to be allocated separate physical machines. This can be avoided by creating isolated virtual entities for each user on the same physical machine. So virtualization is a tool for efficient utilization of resources. It can also serve as a tool for energy saving. Workload consolidation and server consolidation can be used to reduce energy consumption. When servers are overloaded, the virtual machines on the server can be transported to other underloaded servers. And if there are many underloaded servers, just we are talking about the virtualization technologies for a data center. So if there are many underloaded servers, the virtual machines can be consolidated to one or more servers, enabling the ideal servers to be switched off. There are various simulators to simulate the cloud computing environment, but not many of them measure the energy efficiency of a cloud. To tackle this issue, the Green Cloud Simulator was developed in 2013 by a team led at the University of Luxembourg. This provides a fine-grained simulation of energy-efficient clouds. The simulator focuses on the communication between the various elements in the cloud. This approach it adapted adds more than 30% of a total energy and is consumed by the elements for communication. Then there are various works in the literature that falls under area of green cloud computing. There are energy efficient scheduling strategies that make use of virtual machine migrations. Green routing aims to provide routing services in an energy efficient manner. Green networking is the area that focuses on energy efficiency issues in the networking. Another notable work in this area is the Green Cloud Architecture proposed by the scientists Garg and Bhuiya. This proposes a framework that curbs the energy consumption of the cloud. The proposed architecture with an intermediate layer called as a green broker, and which is mostly used in a data center who are going to implement solar PV system. This green broker makes use of directory that contains a carbon emission details of various cloud providers. So as provide greenest provider to the customer at the same time maximizing the profit. Then the carbon emission information of various cloud providers at infrastructure as a service level is measured by a energy meter. At the platform as a service level, energy profiling tools are used. So there are different kinds of energy profiling tools. The energy saving strategies for a data center can be divided into different sections. The section consists of energy efficient techniques for servers, then energy efficient techniques for networks, then energy efficient techniques for servers and networks, also cooling and renewable energy. So the one of the strategies that is called as cooling and renewable energy, and which is adopted by data center. So under this category, notable work has been done, and where it's an attempt to made reduce the energy used by a data center. This include methods such as using renewable energy to power the data center and so on. So in this energy awareness of data center management, these are adoption of the different kinds of experiment in the data center. And nowadays there is a trend of modern green cloud data center, or it's a implementation of the different green energy sources, where they are going to create energy with the help of different solar panel, with the help of the different kinds of environmental availability. As we know that the modern data center, which will require lower power computing platform, and which is a famous for that. Anyhow, the final goal is that how to minimize the energy as well as how to minimize the emission of the CO2, so that it will be very healthy for the environment also, and definitely it will be good for the running the data center as well as running the cloud computing platform in the scenario of the this green cloud. So this is about the green cloud concepts and all. Thank you.